In this particular tips and tricks video for Videos Max, I want to talk about the object snaps. So every Max user does know how to activate the move transform. So I'm just going to select the object, going to do right click and activate move. And then we have several options how we would like to move this object, right? So in this particular scenario, the X is highlighted because it's yellow. So if I select the X arrow key, I'm able to move in the X direction. Similar for the Y, the Z axis, the three planes. So we have the XY plane, we have the ZX plane, we have the YZ plane, and the square icon is just the XYZ move in all directions. So when I start using snaps, I can use the S shortcut key, or I can activate the snaps in the main toolbar located down here. So I'm activating this, I'm gonna go to the settings, so I'm just right clicking. So this will open up the grid and snap settings dialog, where I'm able to set which object snaps I would like to use. So in this particular example, I don't need grid points, just gonna switch them off. I'm gonna activate the endpoint object snap. So what's happening now, if I still hover over the axe, all the axes are highlighted, so it will move in all directions. And this is not particular what I want. So to change the default values, what you need to do is just go into the options tab of the snaps, and in the translation section of the dialog, enable the axis constraints. This is not switched on by default. I don't know why. It would make sense, in my humble opinion, to activate it by default. So when I now hover over the axe, only the axe is highlighted. So then I'm able to start snapping to a different object. So if I can, I can hover over to the endpoint, or if I want, I can select this endpoint, hold the left mouse button, obviously, and then I'm snapping to this point. This is also working with sub-objects. So if I convert this object into an editable poly, convert to editable poly, I'm going into vertex sub-object mode. We can do that by pressing the number one key on your keyboard or just activating the vertex. I'm selecting the particular vertex, and then I'm still able to start moving in the Z direction while I'm selecting different points on another object. So it works in this option as well. So in general, in the snaps, activate the enable axis constraints. That will help you a lot.